So here's the answer. We can define a procedure named replace by. It takes one parameter as its input. I'll call the parameter p. We could call it spy, and that might be a more natural name for it here. But to avoid confusion with the variable spy we're using in the example, I'll call it p. For the body of replace spy, what we want to do is change the value in position 2 of the value passed in. So we can do that with an assignment statement. On the left side, we're selecting the cell, and we're replacing it with a value that we get from the old value in that position plus 1. So this has the behavior that we want. And to have a better understanding why, let's see what happens when we pass a value to a procedure. So here's what we had before the call. We've initialized the variable spy to hold the list containing three elements that are numbers 007. Then we make the call to replace spy, passing in spy. What happens when we call a procedure? The name of the variable in the procedure now refers to the object that's passed in. So now the value of p of the parameter here refers to that object. Then we do the assignment. We replace the value in position 2 of p with its previous value, plus 1. So that changes this value to 8. The parameter p and the variable spy both refer to the same object. So that also changes the value of spy. Note that there's no return statement here. We don't need to return a new value. We've modified the value of the list that was passed in. And I want to emphasize that this is different from what's happened in other procedures. If you remember in an earlier exercise, you defined the procedure inc. It takes one input, we'll call it n, and it adds 1 to that. If we remove the return statement from inc, it doesn't change the value that's passed in. It does nothing. And here's why. So suppose we had code like this. We'll introduce a variable a, give it the value 3. We'll call inc on a. So what happens here? Well, the variable a, that name refers to the value 3. When we pass that to inc, well, the same thing happens as happened when we passed the mutable list as parameter p to replace by. The name n now refers to the same value as a referred to. But we can't mutate that value. What happens inside inc is an assignment statement. We assign to n the value n plus 1. So that changes the value n refers to. Now n refers to a value 4. But that doesn't change the value a refers to. A still has the value 3. So we can see with numbers, we can't mutate the value of a number. If we could, everywhere the value 3 existed before, well, now it would mean 4. That would be pretty confusing.